Hello and welcome to Let's Play Final Fantasy VII Part 30. We have been trying to gather up all of the huge materials and make sure that Shinra do not get their hands on them. And we have been successful so far, but there's one more still to get, and that is in Rocket Town, so here we are. Hey, I see some Shinra soldiers on the rocket. They are trying to defend the huge materia from us, but not for long. One by one, they are all going to die. And you. Okay, easy work. Hey, it's Wesker.
Hi, Wesker.
Okay, Wesker's coming along. We are going to kick the Shinra out of this rocket. We are all ready. Let's go.
Up the ladder.
I wonder who we'll find up here. We've been doing too much side questing lately, and now we are going to continue on with the story. Okay, last enemies. Rude, what are you doing up here? I thought the last time I was going to see you was in the sunken ship. Okay, time for a boss battle. But has Rude or any of the Turks ever been much of a problem, really? Nah.
Goodbye!
Okay, it's just me and Rude. A fair fight to the death. Just me and Rude and Wesker and Anaki. I wonder how long he'll last. Oh. And he didn't even get a chance to shuffle away slowly. Poor Rude. Now we are going to take the huge materia back for ourselves. Although, to be honest, it seems kind of selfish, because this seems like a genuine gesture from Shinra to go and save the planet from the meteor. They're getting the huge materia in this rocket, they're going to ride it off into space, they're going to ram the meteor, and hopefully save the planet. But we're going to take back the huge materia anyway.
Sorry, mate.
And now, we are going to go and try and find the huge materia. It's on the ship somewhere. Good question. What are you doing? How dare you do this without Wesker? Yep, they're going to launch the rocket. Don't act so surprised. I mean, the rocket is on, you know? It's obvious they are going to fly it into space. They've got the huge materia on the rocket. Why else would they be doing this? Come on! Okay, so suddenly Wesker's interested. He wants to know how things are going. But, they're going to use autopilot. That makes sense, no one wants to kill themselves flying into a meteor. One bit's broken and Shearer's doing the repairs. That's gonna take ages. Remember what happened the first time. What? Wesker? What are you talking about? Wesker's saying, he'll do it. Never mind about the autopilot. He'll fly the rocket. But that's suicide. Wesker, come on. Is your dream really that important? To become the first man in space? You'll die. That's not a good idea. I mean, we want to use this huge materia against Sephiroth. There is still the approaching meteor, and Wesker is thinking about piloting the rocket into the meteor, not just as a selfless act, but possibly to achieve his dream of going out into space. This could be his only chance. But that is suicide. We don't want to lose Wesker. But I think he really wants to believe in this idea. This rocket is going to save the planet, and he is going to be the one to pilot the rocket. This isn't Shinra's rocket, this is Wesker's rocket. Nobody touches Wesker's rocket, except Shearer.
And that sounds so wrong. The shame, the shame, the shame. I love it.
What's going on? It looks like this rocket is getting ready to go, but we're not ready. Palmer? That fat person that eats lard. What are you doing? Oh, I see. The autopilot is already complete. It's ready. Typical. Well, thanks a lot, Shearer, for being so damn efficient. Now they are going to send the rocket into space with us needlessly inside it. Thanks a lot.
Oh no, the countdown has already been initiated. We are going into space.
This isn't good.
I wonder if it's going to do it this time. So much for health and safety.
We did it! We are in space!
Wesker has achieved his dream.
We didn't get a chance to escape though, thanks to Palmer. Let's see the course. Straight into the meteor. Uh-oh. This isn't good! And we can't turn the autopilot off.
Well, that's great! Now what are we gonna do? I don't want to die.
Okay, so Wesker thinks there might be another way. Tell me. He keeps an escape pod. Whew, that's good. We are going to live after all. Yeah, what about the huge materia? I mean, we're here now. We could allow the Shinra to have their plan, which might not work, or we could take the huge materia and leave in the pod. Right, so Wesker's saying we can go and get the huge materia. Basically, he's achieved his dream, he's gone into space, he's happy. As for the huge materia, we can do what we want, so let's go and get it. Should be right in here. Whoa, look at this place. So we need to input a passcode.
Oh no.
I don't know the passcode. No. Circle, X, triangle, square. Okay. Random code. Okay. Triangle, square, circle, X. No. Damn. We got it wrong, so now we have a timer. Perfect. Okay. Triangle, circle, square, okay, slowly, Wesker's going to give us clues, and we're going to figure this out. Triangle, X, square, circle? The third digit is X, okay. Square, circle, X, square. No? Okay, triangle, I'll use triangle, square, X, square. God, okay. Triangle, circle, X, circle. I didn't use an X. Okay, so it's definitely not. Second one's definitely not an X. You push the circle once. Okay. Triangle, circle, X, square. The last one is a... Okay. Circle,
square, X, triangle. No, what? You have to push something twice. Okay, circle, square, X, square? I've forgotten what I've done now. Okay. Circle, triangle, X, X? It means you don't use a triangle. Square, circle, X, X. I didn't use an X, but... Okay. Triangle, circle... Sorry about this. I'm just trying to work this out. Okay. Circle, square, X, X. Hooray! Great! Okay. Sorry about that. I think the only one of Wesker's clues I was actually committing to was the X as the third one. Never mind, we got there in the end. We got the huge materia. And now we can go. Oh yeah, also I want to say, in post-production editing, I'm going to be replacing this music with a version of Sid's theme, which I really like, by Chris Holland. He does these really good guitar instrumentals, so if you like that kind of thing, you should go and check out his YouTube page. Once again, he said I could use his recordings for my LP, so thanks! Whoa, what's happening here? Shira? What are you doing on the rocket? Wow, it appears the rocket has blown up somewhat, and Wesker has got himself trapped. Never a good thing, really. This rickety old rocket. I wonder what it is that caused it to blow. Oh yeah! We could leave right now. We can leave, get onto the escape pod. We'll be okay.
But we're not leaving Wesker. He's our friend.
Whoa! He's got quite a foul mouth.
Blimey.
Well, sorry, Wesker. But, you know, we're going to help you because we're nice. Tank 8 blew up. Ah, Tank 8 is the one that Shira was trying to fix all that time ago. And Wesker didn't listen.
You fool, Wesker. You don't argue with women. Women are always right, even when they're wrong.
Hey, it's Shira.
And she's come to help.
Oh, there he goes, straight back into his foul language.
Ha!
That's right. Admit that you were wrong.
Okay, looks like we're going to escape.
To the escape pod!
Let's go.
Here it is.
And Wesker's not going to die after all.
Does it work?
It better work.
I don't want to go into an escape pod which might possibly go straight into the meteor. That would defeat the point of it all.
Okay, so here we go. We have detached from the main rocket, which is flying straight into the meteor. And we're going off in the escape pod. Wow. So this is space.
What a view.
There's a star, and over there's a star, and... a star over there, and over there, to the left.
There's a UFO!
Only joking, it's a star.
And over there?
Fireflies. Stuck in that big bluish-black thing. The pod goes straight back to the planet, burning up as it enters the atmosphere. While Shinra 26,
the rocket,
flies straight on course to the meteor.
Say goodbye, rocket!
Wow. I hope this works! Did we destroy the meteor? Oh, come on, don't give me the talk show dramatic pause. We've got to know. Is the planet going to be okay? Uh-oh. What's that sound? That doesn't sound good. And so, the meteor has not been completely obliterated. It's still there, in lots of little pieces. Still big enough to survive the journey onto the planet. Ah. Well, so much for that plan. But luckily, we got the huge materia out just in time. Now our only hope is to stop Sephiroth. Yes, look how disappointed he is.
It didn't work.
Never mind. And just think, all of these people are now without hope. Shinra have failed, but fear not. Because we're gonna save the world now. But we are going to do it better. Because we have a great team. We have a vampire guy, we've got this stuffed teddy bear thing, we've got a dog, we've got a ninja thief idiot person, we've got a woman with quite large... Yeah, and we've got a pilot guy, we've got a guy with a gun arm, and we've got me. I'm quite confident that we shall save this world. How are we going to do it? I don't know, but we have the huge materia, and that's a start. So, well, first things first. So, what are we going to do? I mean, it's easy enough to say, we're going to save the world, but how? How are we going to do it? Come on. I mean, how can we possibly hope to save the world from this? We have Shinra, we've still got the weapons walking around the planet, we have to take care of them. We have Sephiroth, we've got Genova, we've got the meteor. I mean, what can we hope to do? Where do you start? I think that we need some advice from someone wise, someone incredibly clever. What does Wesker have to say? I always thought this planet was so huge, but looking at it from space, I realized it's so small. We're just floating in the dark, and it kind of makes you feel powerless. On top of that, it's got Sephiroth festering inside it like a disease. That's why I say this planet's still a kid. A little kid, sick and trembling in the middle of this huge universe. Someone's got to protect it. You follow me? That someone is us.
Wesker! That was beautiful!
I'm not saying yo. Okay, well, it even got to Bongo. What an amazing speech. Okay, so, what are we going to do to protect the planet? Tell us, Wesker, with your wise words. What are we going to do? You're still thinking about that. We've been thinking about this for ages!
But what? What are we going to do? We've been asking the same question for the last 5 minutes.
Now, I stopped side questing so we can continue on with the story. Now, I can appreciate that saving the world isn't as easy as Grey Fox makes it look, but we've got to do this. So, please, decide on where we are going next. I mean, listen, we can hear the planet is dying.
And we know that because that's what Bugenhagen said.
So I say that we go and visit Bugenhagen because he is wise. He is a wise man. The first thing you must know about him is that he is wise. The second is that he's a man.
Hi, Bugenhagen.
It's me, Chris, with Nanaki and Wesker.
What?
You actually openly say, oh, you've come to seek my wisdom. You think you're so smart, don't you? You think you're so clever. Just because you've got a beard. I mean, you're not that smart, although we would like some advice about where to go next because we need to talk to someone that's quite clever. Although you're not as clever as me, because I'm quite clever as well, because I'm the leader of this party.
Okay, you're cleverer than me, I admit it.
But don't you think, for 1 second, that I will admit it in front of the other party members? Hello? I've gathered you all here today to tell you that Bugenhagen stupid. Oh, sorry, stupid. No offense. Bugenhagen, don't think for one second you are stealing stupid's title. Oh, yeah. About this meteor and about Sephiroth and all this stuff, Renette was going to do something. Back in Disc 1, she was going to transummon something to try and save the planet from all of this. Some sort of countermeasure against the meteor, because Renette was half Citra, so she still had some sort of special connection to the planet, so she could possibly summon something which might ruin Sephiroth's plans. She was a threat. And so she had to die. She was the only one who could have done it, so I'm not sure if we have any hope of carrying on what she tried to do. But we could look for clues. Maybe if we went back to where it all happened. Back to the City of Ancients. And Bugenhagen is coming too. He's feeling a new energy. It must be the planet calling to you. The planet calling. Right. Wesker, I find your lack of faith disturbing. So don't go all Han Solo on us, because I believe the Ancients had great power. And Renette was half ancient, and she had a piece of materia she carried around that did absolutely nothing. Oh yeah, that's not very good. Well, anyway, we've got some huge materia. We want to store it somewhere. So let's go and put it up here. In the machine. Yeah, look at that. Okay, so we got all of the huge materias. Yes, it is. And we collected it because we are great. We got some on a train, we got some fighting a war, we got some on a submarine, and we got some in space. So the green one's the magic coloured one. This one is the summon materia colour. This one is yellow, so it is the command materia. And this one is blue. Huh? Barmot? Barmot Neo Barmot. Wow. Looks like getting the huge materia paid off. We got Barmot Zero. And I've heard all sorts of pronunciations for these things, and I'm sorry if I pronounce it wrong, okay? I'm sorry! If this game was like Final Fantasy VIII, you would be able to rename them. Then I could give the summon the name of my dreams. And it'd be something simple and bland. Yes, it does smell of machinery. You know why? Because it is machinery. Well done, oh great smart one. You have an excellent nose, and I'm sure if the graphics of this game were slightly more realistic, it would be a big nose, a massive one. Wow, he can fly. Okay, so we are heading to the City of the Ancients. We're going to do a bit of detective work, see what we missed. You never know, Renette might have left a clue, something that she was trying to do to save the planet from a meteor. Bugenhagen might possibly turn out in some strange twist to be a Citra. He's old enough, he has glasses and a bald head, he's very wise, and he has a special connection to the planet. You never know, anything could happen. This story is crazy! Or we could, you know, try to trick the planet by dressing up as Renette and pretending to be ancients. It might work. But anyway, we'll have to find out that later, because I'm cutting off the video here, so thank you for watching, and I shall see you next time. Bye!